like hello. But it has a deeper meaning associated with it. It means, I respect the soul and spirit in you that is also in me. Today, as I wish namaste to all of you present here, I also respect the commitment and inspiration that each of you have to be a great leader and a great communicator. Mr. Toastmasters, fellow members, and most welcome guests, I am very glad today to be giving my first icebreaker speech. As I was thinking of topics that what about me would you be most interested to hear, I remembered Melissa's last speech where she said that the question, who am I, cannot be answered by just telling about where I was born or where I currently work. So in today's speech, I would like to answer the question in such a way that you get to know me better as a person. I will speak about 3 points from my background and some lessons that life has taught me. My background, that is my family, my education, and my current job. I am grateful to God for the greatest gift ever, that is my family. My parents and grandparents have taught me to always care for others before oneself. My parents did not get an opportunity to attend college, but they have ensured that each of their children receive the best possible education. I am grateful and fortunate to have studied at some of the best institutions in the world. This journey has given me immense pleasure and has taken me to various places in India and then to US for my masters. Along the way, I have met various talented people and I have made friends that can hold me in good stead throughout my life. And I'm also glad that after this years of education, I'm starting my working career here in Silicon Valley, where technology revolution happens. This description of my background leads me to the second point that I want to discuss today. I firmly believe in the power of karma and destiny. I have experienced it in my life that has given me enough courage and motivation to continue doing it for the rest of my life. Believing in karma is like a paradigm or like following a religion. It gives me hope every day. And someone has rightly said, the only point in living is knowing that the best is yet to come. The third point I want to discuss today is about the power of dreams. If you want to achieve the impossible, you should dream about it and then do the right actions or the good karma to achieve it. Karma and dreams are both the two sides of the same coin. You keep playing with it, you keep repeating it every day, and only then the result will be in your favor. Again, I'm speaking from personal experience. I dream a lot, and sometimes some of them break. But I don't get disheartened because I know if I keep doing the right actions, the good karma, all of them will come true one day. Before I end my speech today, I would like to share an incident from my childhood days. I was shy to speak in front of a group of people. In one of our classes, we used to study the play Julius Caesar by Shakespeare. I used to love the play a lot, as well as all the great speeches in them. I have fond memories of I standing in front of a mirror or by myself in a room and giving all those speeches. But today, as I got this opportunity to give my first speech to you all, I would like to end that speech by quoting a few lines from Mark Antony's funeral speech of Julius Caesar. So here it goes. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come here to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do, live after them, the good of interred with their bones. So let it be with Caesar.